Hello, and how's it going, everyone? It is Skullzy here with the latest and the greatest gaming news. Today I have yet another Bethesda Roundup video for you all, where I'll be breaking down all the most recent Bethesda news, rumors, and speculation, and today I have quite a lot to talk about, which is a surprise. However, some of these stories are small, but there is some pretty big and interesting trending stories mixed into things, along with some actual confirmed information regarding Starfield, and this piece of confirmed information for Starfield has been known about for some time. However, it seems like the majority of the community doesn't actually know about it, so it's been circulated again recently, so I figured I too would do my part and share it with you all again, just in case everyone needs to be reminded of this, or in case you actually don't know about this piece of confirmed Starfield information. But I got a lot to talk about today. I'm going to be talking about a cancelled Obsidian version of Starfield, which is pretty interesting. Microsoft did a naughty thing that everyone is mad at them for, which I'll be breaking down in today's video. Bethesda wants you to spend like $1,000 on $80 worth of jewelry and a couple other small but interesting things. Usually content creators and streamers could afford pretty awesome backgrounds with a bunch of Cyberpunk 2077 neon lights and like a bunch of cool little characters and stuff. Here I am with my bottle of water. But you don't care about my water! Let's not waste any more time and let's get to today's news. Now I'm gonna start things off with this huge trending Microsoft thing because it's all that any gaming journalist is talking about right now, because Microsoft literally, I believe today, just announced that here real soon they will be increasing the prices of their Xbox Live Gold subscription, which, I mean, yeah, increase the prices during a pandemic, especially when you aren't inherently offering anything alongside the price increase because you don't have a ton of new content. There's no like Disney Plus stuff going on with Xbox Live Gold. There's no real reason to justify this price increase. And yes, Game Pass is getting a lot of new stuff, especially with Bethesda. However, that's not right now. So maybe wait to increase the price until you have a lot more content to like actually constitute this price increase. But nonetheless, I'm gonna break it all down today. And in order to get to the details of all this, I'll have to activate glasses mode. But don't worry, I'm fine. Man, that joke is horrible. Wow, that's stupid. I'm gonna go. But here are the details on why Xbox wants to take all your money during an economic crisis. And yes, you could argue that gaming and the subscription is a luxury. Of course, that's true, that's valid. Totally understandable. You shouldn't be spending money on games if you don't have money to actually, like, pay for your bills and food and stuff. But the point is, to double your prices during a pandemic, or do what Xbox is doing here, is kind of shady, and I'll show you why. Now, to start things off, it's gonna seem kinda small here, but just hang on, because it kinda escalates quickly. For the 1 month Xbox Gold subscription, they're increasing that price by $1, which will basically be making it $11 a month. And then the 3 month subscription will be increased by $5. So essentially 3 months will be $30 and a 6 month subscription will be $60. But here's the thing, if you don't subscribe to Xbox Gold, your prices are essentially doubling, going from a year, which would be otherwise $60, to actually $120 now. 6 months of Xbox Live Gold is $60, which used to be the literal price you could pay for an entire year. So yes, their prices are doubling. What you used to pay for a year only gets you 6 months now, and to make that decision during an economic crisis, during a literal pandemic, is super greedy. And I know Xbox loves green color good, and money green too, so Xbox also love money. Nom nom nom, eat money durr. I know, Xbox, I get it. You want to make as much money as possible, but to make this decision right now is a PR nightmare. Especially when you could have waited X amount of time for you to get a lot of those Bethesda games added to the Game Pass lineup. And it's like you're trying to bully people into like getting Game Pass. And bear in mind, with Xbox, you can't play free-to-play games like Call of Duty Warzone unless you actually get into the subscription service. So it's like the value here does not warrant a double in your price. It's nothing makes sense here. It's odd, and it seems like maybe maybe Microsoft is trying to make some of that Bethesda money back, some of that $7 billion, but I don't think that's the case here. I've seen comments like that, and I know a lot of people want to think that's the case, but Microsoft has a ton of money here. I doubt they need to resort to these kind of tactics to make money back, but to be honest, I don't work at Microsoft. I'm not sure. But either way, this price increase definitely isn't worth it on a technical level, even when you discount all the current, like, economic crisis is going on right now all over the world. But enough bad story time, let's talk about something that's kind of interesting, but doesn't exist anymore, unfortunately. Obsidian was kind of making their own version of Starfield, or a Skyrim with sci-fi vibes that even apparently had time travel. Basically, this was going to be a massive role-playing sci-fi game featuring guns, time travel, and alien invasion, all built on Skyrim's engine, apparently, utilizing the Skyrim Radiant AI system very heavily, and this game was called Backspace. It's a project that was being developed by Obsidian at some point in time, way back in 2011, and although the development progress never got very far, it was a very ambitious project, and one thing this actually directly reminds me of is Bethesda's The Tenth Planet, which is a canceled game that they were working on in the 90s that seemed very ambitious and actually had an alien invasion where you had to work to defend the invasion. You had to, like, kind of direct strategically where the defenses would go, and there was realistic planetary orbits, and it seemed like a pretty ambitious project for the time. And this was back in the 90s, and obviously Bethesda never made the game because it was way too ambitious for the time, and it seems like those vibes kind of carry over with whatever Backspace was. But apparently Backspace was mostly just a project concept and was never actually officially canceled because it wasn't truly, like, started in the first place. It was just, like, on a drawing board and maybe some assets were made, and it was considered heavily, but they never went through with the project, unfortunately, which, if they would have, imagine if Obsidian would have made a game similar to Starfield, only they would have gotten it out before Starfield. That would have been amazing. And yes, The Outer Worlds is a space sci-fi game. Maybe The Outer Worlds is what they ended up going with, and The Outer Worlds was inspired with their original vision with Backspace, but nonetheless, it's interesting to hear that Obsidian, a direct competitor to Bethesda Game Studios, if not their biggest direct competitor in terms of just, like, concepts and creativity and just game types, was actually making a game similar to what they're working on now, which is Starfield. Next up, someone I actually know in the Bethesda community, Chad of Fallout 76 Podcast, who I've actually had the pleasure to work with during a charity event recently with Fallout 76. Great content, great person, great community, and Chad's actually recreated Bioshock's Rapture within Fallout 76 to a certain degree, and it's actually very, very well done. There's videos of it on Chad's YouTube channel. I highly suggest you watch this if you're interested in Fallout 76 and you're a Bioshock fan. It's cool to see just the level of creativity that exists within Fallout's building system in Fallout 76, and I remember the main reason I actually implemented the building system in the Fallout 4 originally is because Todd Howard and the team were just surprised at the creativity that people were able to express with the in-game building system, with the in-game structure and town building system, and because of this and because of creations like this that we're seeing from Chad and other great members in the Fallout community, I am sure there will be somewhat of a settlement or, like, a structure building system in the least in Starfield and the Elder Scrolls 6 and beyond, because it just seems like a great way to get the community to share their stuff and keep the community engaged via social media and keep people talking about your game. And now we're going to talk about that confirmed Starfield information, but keep in mind, like I said at the beginning of this video, this has been known about for a very, very, very long time now. However, a lot of people have been asking if Starfield will have spaceflight, as if it hasn't been confirmed already. It has been. There's been a lot of people, even in my videos recently, asking if Starfield will have spaceflight all over Reddit, all over the place, and had to put my glasses on off camera there, that's why they appeared on my face. But Johnny Spite over on Starfield's Reddit was kind of thinking the same thing I was, and because he made this post over there and it's received a lot of thumbs up, and even the first comment is like, hey, this has been known about for a while, but a lot of people don't seem to know this, so I figured I would do my part and share this with the community as well. For those who maybe are new to Starfield and don't know what's confirmed yet, or those who have, like, been in the community for a while and somehow this information has eluded you. But during that legendary scary and meme-worthy E3 2019 chat between Todd Howard and Elon Musk, Todd Howard said, traveling in space in his game, meaning in Starfield, he wants to say it's like flight in the 1940s. It's dangerous, and it's still dangerous to go out and explore, even though lots of people do it. Todd Howard goes on to say that Starfield shouldn't be confused with a rocket engineering sim like Kerbal Space Program, but it is like, it's somewhat realistic but gamified a bit, so it's able to be accessed as an RPG rather than just a straight up simulation, and be more accessible by the general gaming audience as well, because we know your average gamer isn't out there playing Kerbal Space Program. But as my glasses disappear off my face, so should any doubt that there will be space travel in Starfield. Like I said, this has been known about since E3 2019. Starfield is confirmed to have space travel. Send the word, send space Paul Revere out there into the asteroid belt to shoot flares. I'm not going to continue with this metaphor, but send the word, it's confirmed, space travel is in Starfield, has been known about for more than a year now, and, like, even though this has been known about for a long time, I still figured I would share this with you all today, just based upon how many people out there don't know this information. Next up, do you want to spend $1,000 on, like, $80 worth of gold to show your loved one that you love them? Well, now, thanks to Bethesda, you can. And, disclaimer, before I get too far into this is just how jewelry goes. Jewelry is always upmarked. Bethesda isn't nefarious for doing this or being shady, but it is just kind of silly to actually break down the true value of what you're getting here. But hey, if you've got a ton of money, if you've got enough septums to drop one stack, $1,000 on one ring and not two rings as pictured here, then I guess why not, right? Why not show someone you love them if you're both into the Elder Scrolls and ESO with something like this? But the Ritual of Mara, 10k gold ring, you can get that now for $1,000, and it's obviously tailored towards Valentine's Day, but bear in mind, you won't even get this ring for Valentine's Day. You'll get it like maybe in April or beyond. So if you're gonna get this ring, don't expect it to give it to your loved one on Valentine's Day. And if you expect to get two, you're getting one ring. I don't know why they show two here. That's borderline shady. But this ring's $1,000, right? It's a 10k carat gold ring. Most rings weigh like 3 to 5 grams on average. This ring doesn't seem to have any additional ornaments or gemstones or anything, so it's probably just going to be pure gold ring weight here, and the engravings may even take away from the ring weight a little bit, so let's just put that in the average, and let's say it's like between 4 to 4.5, maybe even 5 grams of gold weight, and it's 10 karat gold, and 10 karat gold is worth about $25 a gram as of right now, I believe, which would place the actual, like, value of this ring just under or around $100, and you're paying $1,000 for this. This ring doesn't have any adornments or anything. It has cool-ass engravings, really cool lore-relative engravings, which is awesome. It's great, but to 10 times that price, I mean, it seems shady, but it's not. I've seen a lot of people in the community sharing this and saying, oh, Bethesda's up to it again. Bethesda's trying to reach into your pocketbook and take your money for something that it is worth a lot less. That's not the case here. If you're buying jewelry, you have burnable income. You're not going to buy jewelry unless you have that extra money, right? And that's what this is. Not only is this jewelry, but it's love-themed Valentine's Day jewelry, which is like the most capitalistic holiday of them all. Spend money on your loved one to prove love, and you add jewelry into that mix, you're going to get overpriced stuff. But this is still kind of cool. If I could afford this ring, and I'd probably get it, because it's like a limited opportunity kind of thing here, right? You're only going to have one chance to get this somewhat lore-relevant ring to the Elder Scrolls universe. But either way, I figured I'd give you my opinion on this, because it's another thing I've seen floating out there in the community. And the last thing I want to mention real quick in today's video, I'm literally just going to mention and walk away from. There are even more contract-based quality assurance game testers being hired by Bethesda Game Studios in Rockville, Maryland, and since this is a contract-related job position, it means it's for a limited time only, and what's the next game coming from Bethesda Game Studios in Rockville, Maryland? Starfield. So, I keep saying this every time I see one of these job postings go up, or I see this job posting get posted again and again, but like the Starfield space thing, I do want to remind the community that Starfield is 100% in the game testing phase right now, meaning that all development is probably shifted over to the Elder Scrolls 6 if it hasn't already, like a year or two from now. Who knows how long Starfield has been in the development stage. There's quotes from Todd Howard back in E3 2018 that seems to indicate Starfield could have mostly only been in game testing back then and not in development either. But like I said, this is just more confirmation that as of right now, Starfield is lining up to be released at some point soon, which is more evidence of a November 2021 release date. And with that in mind, we should hear something at E3 June 2021 or whatever Bethesda's gonna do around then if E3 doesn't happen. But that's everything I wanted to talk about in today's video. I'm still fine. My water's still over there. It's decorative. If you like the video, if you enjoy the content, be sure to give the video a thumbs up, subscribe, and turn notifications on. And if you want to help grow the channel and the community, be sure to share the content, share the video, get people to subscribe, as channels only literally grow if the subscribers share the content. And speaking of that, the algorithm hasn't been sharing my content. However, since I've been asking you all to share my content, it has. So thank you very much. Keep sharing my videos. Keep getting people to subscribe and making people aware of the channel, because that is helping the algorithm be aware of my channel, and the channel is finally growing. Thanks to you. Greatly appreciate it. Keep doing what you're doing. And speaking of appreciation, huge shout out to these amazing people for going above and beyond in supporting the channel and bringing you content like this. If you've supported the channel this week, like I keep saying, I will update this list at the end of this week. I just wanted to say that again to let you know if you're concerned that you haven't seen your name added to this list yet. Don't worry, a lot of you all have been awesome this week. I've gotten a lot more support, a lot more donations. I will update this list on Sunday at the end of the week with all the new supporters. So if you want to get your name added to this list and get a future video shout out permanently in every one of my videos from this point forward, now is your chance before I update this list on Sunday. You can do so by supporting the channel over on Ko-fi, Patreon, or here on YouTube as an exclusive channel member. Links to all this and more are down in the description below. And as always, thank you for watching. Be sure to tune in next time when my bottle of water is decorative, damn it.
It just works.